it's very helpful. I was speaking to his manager, Nicky Elliott, suggested, and Nicky's really, really cut up about it. They've been sending out tweets and stuff, like, showing the support to his fans. That's very sad.
You guys get punished, don't you? I mean, it's that sort of business.
Well, come on, man. You know what I mean? I'm even close to Glenn. I'm not even like him. We are very close. That's a boxer's family. That's our family. Yeah, we are. So it's everybody's cut up about it. It's hurtful.
Must be hard. Yeah, what about you, man?
About
you've done well.
Done very well. You know, it's amazing because just the other day, just last year, the fight came up again at Christmas time, and I said, "Yeah, I'm going to take it. You know, I'm going to take it for the wrong reasons. I'm going to take it for money." And Spencer said to me, "You know, he was screaming and shouting, saying, you know, don't take it for money. You take it if you think you can win it." So
you moved down from Glasgow. Yeah. You were living in a gym, so I hear.
Yeah.
Tough or hard?
Yeah, it was really hard. Yeah. I mean, before I was staying at John Mooney's gym, I didn't want to turn pro again. I mean, I came to London, you know, in just to take a PT, doing PT then. And then I came and, you know, I decided to go and take up a boxing again. And that'd be expensive for a lot of them, yeah.
I mentioned the fight. Were you confident when you got the fight at short notice as well?
Yeah. I mean, I thought inside that I could do it.
So,
yeah.
Why were you so confident?
I don't think I got the start to beat everyone.
Have you worked with him before?
I've sparred before in the gym. We did about four.